Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. Those who are new, welcome to my channel.
In today's class, let us see Buddhism. Siddhartha, who later became or known as the Gautama Buddha, who was born in 6th century BCE. His father was Suddhodana. He was a king of Republic of Shakya. Siddhartha, who was left the kingly and luxurious and familial happy life, Siddhartha became a hermit. Disillusion and prevailing way of his life. He embarked upon a quest for truth. Attaining enlightenment. After attaining the enlightenment, he became Buddha. Buddha means enlightened one. And he first went to
Saranath near Banaras.
There is a deer park and he gave his first sermon. This has been called as a Dharma Chakra Parivartana. Here he preaches the Four Noble Truths and Eightfold Paths. The Four Noble Truths declare that the whole world is full of sorrow and sufferings. They also explain the root causes of sorrows, and Buddha realized that the desires was the root causes of all sorrows. Only by the liberation of excessive desires could be peaceful life be led. Buddha teaches or preaches the Eightfold Paths for eliminating desires. These are called as a middle path. Those are action, speech, vision, livelihood, effort, recollection, resolve, thoughts. Those are all the Eightfold Paths of Buddhas. Now let us move on. The followers of a new religion. Wealthy merchants, artisans and common peoples, they were inspired by the new teaching of Buddha. Buddha gave his message in Prakrit language. On that time, Prakrit language was used by the common people and related them to the various aspects of their traditions. The atmosphere of the new cities changes the way of life of the peoples. The new religion became a ray of hope in the changes of circumstances on that time. Buddhism especially took on the new role of the transmission that lives of lives of the people. The Buddha and his followers visited to Kosala, Magadha and many cities on the Gangetic plain and spread his message. There they walked from the city to another city and devoted their lives for the others. In his 80th year, Buddha's glorious life of the selfless service come to an end at Kushinagar. This is called as a Mahaparinirvahana. The viharas were constructed in all the areas which Buddha wandered, and the people preserved his relics and bones in the chaityalayas and stupas, and in the memory of his accomplishment started worshipping him. This was how the first temple ideal and ideal worship was begin. Very famous stupa is Sanchi Stupa. Now let us move on. The Buddhism is spread not only in our India but also in the foreign countries. The Chinese traveler like Fahian, Itsang and Hunutsong, they have described the vivid and different glory of Buddhism in their own work. The Buddhism has spread into Malaya, Burma, Thailand, Vietnam, Cambodia, Sri Lanka and Bamiyan. The rocks have been cut in the mountain and shaped into the statues of Buddha. Even today we can see in different states, different countries also. In the year 1956, inspired by the Buddha's teaching, India's prominent social philosopher and architect of our constitution, Baba Saheb Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, accepted the Buddhism. Now let us move on. After the Buddha's death, his followers was collected his all teachings and traditions in the form of Tripitakas. Those are the Vinaya, Dhamma and Abhidharma. Pitakas. Over the period of time, the disagreement and development in the teaching and different branches of the Buddhism was spring up. Those are the Hinayana, Mahayana, Vajrayana, and their sutras has come into existence. Today we see many organizations across the globe adopting the different way of realizing the Buddha's teaching. This is all about Buddhism and Buddha's life. This is the end of the video. Thank you for watching this. Bye.